Hello folks, and welcome to Erannorth Reborn. Today we will be unlocking a new class or a new race. Let's see. We have the Death Knight and we have the Nymph. And the winner is the Death Knight. So let's see. We get Slashing, Bludgeoning and Dark. And for resistances, we have plus 2 in dark, plus 2 in poison, and a penalty in light. Accept. So if I go and make something like a Vampire Death Knight, look at this. Light, minus 6. If you get 1 damage of light, if 1 damage of light passes you, then you are going to get 7 out of it, which can be quite lethal. On the other hand, you can. The Death Knight is a heavy class, so it doesn't have much action points. They strike hard, but they lack in action points. So playing as a Vampire Death Knight would make up for that, but this would be a problem that you need to be having in your mind. So instead I will do something more less traditional and play as a Nephilim Death Knight. And now, as you can see, we have a light of minus 2 and an astral of minus 2, which is more suitable. On the other hand, our slashing gets a bonus, but our dark gets a penalty, and so is astral, which we don't particularly care about. So this could be a problem, but there are ways to turn your Nephilim over to the dark side and defy their angelic heritage, so it will make for an interesting character. This combo doesn't have much action points per turn. Let's first see what raising our agility could achieve here. We also have the problem of the low intellect. So this combination in a first glance is both slow and doesn't have much of a hand size. Can we make it work? Well, let's find out. First though, I will see if investing to willpower makes things better. Maybe drop our resilience and go for 2 agility. And I think that would be good. So it's here. She used to be a knight, but now she's a death knight and follows the dark path. Let's start in normal and see how we can make things work with this low action points per turn, with this minus 1 dark, but with this nice plus 5 slashing. So we'll be focusing on slashing. We will be making up with light from the Nephilim, and eventually we will be boosting our dark farther. So let's go. So from perks, let's check here and search for dark. And you can see that there are many ways that we can boost our dark. Of course, not all this gives bonus to dark. Angelic Blood, for example, gives penalty to the dark. so you have to check before you take one. Okay, let's clear this out and start. Stiffness. You gain plus one slashing and plus one bludgeoning resistance. So very nice. Of course, we won't be getting angelic blood. And unholy strength. You deal plus one slashing and plus one dark damage. So let's go for unholy strength. Already we have a plus six slashing and a zero penalty in dark. So our serrated blade will hit hard, and let's go to our deck and empty it. At this point it's not like we have lots of options, but let's focus on our slashing cards and make sure that all of them are in. As you can see, they cost quite a lot. So superhuman reflexes. Nephilim card, synergy vulnerable, synergy intense, and quick draw, which lets you redraw your serrated blade. So for 4, you can have this and an additional strike of your serrated blade. 3 and 1 your serrated blade. This is a summon. Vengeance is the Nephilim's, the Death Knight's custom resource, which you can expend or it can boost your various actions. For example, if we have Vengeance 3 or more, we can also craft a Sword Thrust, which is this. And if we have here Vengeance 5 plus, it will inflict more bleed as a bonus effect. Okay, so slashing is good. We have a decent light. So let's get this, which will produce the Nephilim rune blade. We can use the angelic shield, 2 runes of mending, and here we have dark cards. Okay, dark damage won't be much, so Corrupt Arms can help with that. Death Pact can give us Vengeance, and if our hit points is less than 50%, then we craft a passage to the afterlife, which is this, Further Amplify Dark. And use either serve beyond the grave or Gift of Unlife. So let's add one of these. Necrotic Touch will be draining and also controlling undead, so it's quite interesting. Resolve, and let's go one and one. Okay, so this is our starting deck. Very expensive stuff. We currently have only 6 action points that are regenerating per turn. On the bright side, we will be hitting hard, so our hits will be counting. Okay, let's start with Serrated Blade. Add damage here. No, it's ignore synergies. Add it here. Leap of Faith. It's a reaction. Synergy vulnerable. Plus 4, synergy damage plus 2, and again vulnerable, so we gain vulnerable of 4. And we also have counter attack, which gives us retribution, and if we have a retribution of 12 plus, then we can get some synergy damage. Since everything in our deck costs a lot, let's get a little leap of faith. And see if it's nice to have or not. Okay, so we can deal 4 intense damage to someone with that. Or we can use this. We can kill this guy by triggering this ability. 3-6 light, 4-8 slashing, and defend 2 is enough to keep him at bay. No, that ignores synergies, so let's use Inscribe. So we can't make the dog into an undead dog. That would be interesting. So we are evil. Let's put him out of his misery. No animals were harmed during the production of this video. Be assured of that. Let's get the punching dagger, which is not very useful for our character, but we can always sell it, and the mace. Five to ten. Let's start with an echo chain, so we can add corrupt arms to this guy and death pact to this guy, and nope. So our damage energy passed and hit the dwarf. If you remember, echo chains, we discussed them thoroughly. Corrupt Arms gave us a synergy damage, which passed on Death Pact, and it dealt 2-4 damage along with other benefits we got. So 2 and 1. Horned Helmet. It's an automatic accessory, meaning that you do pay 1, whether you like the effect or not. And we also have Cure Feeble Mind, which needs alchemy. And a bow, which we might need. So if the enemy is flanking you, they also get bleed. It has a sneak attack and deals 2-4. Piercing damage. I will get the Horn Helmet, won't equip it at the moment, and the short bow in case we need it. We won't be pursuing alchemy, but we might be pursuing something like occult. We don't have herbalism, so let's continue. Soul Spike meets an ally, deals 3-6 chaotic damage. Our ally gets -4 health, and we get synergy damage. Passage to Afterlife. We can produce this card from our Death Pact too. So we can get the Weakening Touch, which is quite cheap, and we can add synergies to it. Okay, so let's start with Corrupt Arms. I can play this to myself. And that's because there is nothing before it. If it was, I would be playing it to an enemy. And start. Take down one of these. Use a knapsack. Which one should I pick? The offhand dagger or the offhand dagger? I think I will go with this one. I like the attributes more. Necrotic touch. Sensitive blade. As you can see, we are struggling with our action points, but each of our hits count, and they count a lot. Let's get 1, 3, 4. I can quick draw my blade, but this will take only one of them out. Still, I think was the best option in this case. Draw this, use it. Okay, let's play Corrupt Arms, followed by Angelic Shield, and that will and your turn. Blade of Radiance, intense. Let's use Necrotic Touch. And that's it. So we might be struggling with action points, but so far the enemies were easy to deal with. Things will get harder now that the enemies will be tougher, so we will need to be focusing more on one at a time. Corrupt Arms here. Mark, right click. We got a level, which means that we can continue. And that's it. Okay, so we got Scent of Death. Scent of Death has Desecrate, which means that it will harm the living, heal the wicked, and if we have a Desecrate aura active, will deal 2 to 4 damage to 2 random enemies. Yes, I think I will add it to my deck. So, Scent of Death. Let's add 2 of these. Now, I think I will keep it as it is and adjust things accordingly later after we get some more cards. Rune of Punishment, Blessed 4, deals 4 damage to wicked enemies and can banish if they have hit points less than 12. And Holy Strike is pretty nice and quite cheap, so let's add this. Let's Start with serrated blade, superhuman reflexes, hit with weakening touch. Okay, so one survived. Let's use this. We also got a level, which means that we might find a perk that is useful to have. Swift Slash. If you have concealment, no, it's in red. If the enemy has concealment, craft Swift Slash. Deal 5 to 10 slashing damage, and if the enemy dies, you play superhuman reflexes. So, you can read the clarification of what that does here. If you have the non-combat rules, the detailed rules, that is, it would say that if the enemy has concealment, blah blah blah. But I prefer to play with the combat rules. So let's add this. No, I will add this to my stats. We might need it later on. Okay, resolve death pact. These guys deal poison damage, so this won't be much useful. They have concealment and poison and flanking, so retribution won't be very useful either. So let's just try to do as much damage as possible. We can benefit from the vengeance. We have one vengeance left from the previous turn, so let's go with now we will craft the sword thrust because our vengeance is 3. And kill this guy. Okay. Senior the damage to our necrotic touch. We healed some hit points. Defend. Desecrate, I will plate it on myself. Scent of Death, almost grabbed the wrong card. This will heal me because I count as wicked. And add this to my inventory. So let's see. We got perk points. What should we get? There is stiffness, bladed weapon training, blunt weapon training, captivating, heightened reflexes. Heightened reflexes is our first priority. Scent of death, dark mask. So we can get malevolent to boost our dark damage at cost of light. But at this point, heightened reflexing, this is higher priority. And we can go with an agility boost. Stas, Soul Spike. So we already kinda solved our action point problem. Things will be much better for us. So it's where we look at it. This one resists slashing, but it's vulnerable to dark, and this one resists dark, but it's vulnerable to slashing. And I will go for this one because my dark half will deal more damage than my slashing. Not that it made much difference, but we did 2 slashing and 4 dark damage, so she got 5 out of it. Probably would have been the same if I had chosen this, a different target in this particular case. He deals light damage. So that's 3 and 3, 6 and 0. We can bring in But we need a half. We need hit point less than 50% to craft the passage to afterlife. So no need. Corrupt arms myself. Let's use. He's immune to vulnerable, but we don't know that. Vulnerable fails. We get a +2 from our echoing corrupt arms. So let's get rid of this plant. Animals. Study Grimoire. I take this to my hand and continue. Let's use our damage synergy. Hit this guy. Quick draw. Hit this guy. And we are at the second boss, which is Orpheus. He's a light. No, he's a piercing damage hunter. They are all non-wicked though. So let's face my wickedness. Aura of Darkness. Aura of Darkness emits an area, desecrate. Area emits an aura of darkness for X steps. Enemies and allies that count as wicked restore action tier plus evolution hit points. So this is 1 plus 0 hit points. Everyone else suffers action tier plus evolution damage. So 1 damage we heal, 1 damage we deal. At this point lasts for 2 turns. Not much, but better than I think. Quick draw. Let's use it on Orpheus. So, Consecrate dispelled our Aura of Darkness and created an Aura of Light, which is the opposite of what we wanted. So, he lost 1 hit point, we restored 1 hit point, and the Bright Light dispels Aura of Darkness. And we can dispel this Aura of Light by using a Desecrate once more. Because he's what is if he survives our barrage of attacks? No, he didn't. So let's see how much his aura. Blade of Radiance restores 4 hit points because, well, it's not wicked. Aura of Light hurts you, you lose 4 hit points. So his aura was dealing 4 hit points of damage. Let's use End of Death. Next turn, because we will have Desecrate, it will deal 2 to 4 damage to 2 enemies. No, I think this card has a problem. I don't think it will trigger. Probably needs a bug fixing. Where did I put it on me? No, the card is correct, yes. They did, got the chaotic bonus. Because we had Desecrate. That's good. Let's start with this. Celestial Runeblade, burn 1, blessed 12, deal 4 to 9 light damage and unravels for synergy damage. So even if you can't afford it, it's still useful to have, but if the enemy is wicked, then they will suffer a lot with this. So let's add it to our deck, which now has 26 cards. This guy deals physical damage, so I guess we can resist 1. Let's get defend. We can get our vengeance to 3 and get to craft the short thrust. So first let's add this to this guy. good level. We will get Vengeance 3 and craft this old thrust. And we got some nice Nephilim cards. We can't get additional Death Knight cards at the moment because we lack the mastery. But we can potentially earn up to Light Arc for the Nephilim side of things. And perks, we can have this here, dark magic training. Let's get dark magic training to start going a bit on the dark side, and I will save the rest. So we withstood the Trollcuth's attack, and now he will suffer. He got extra damage from the silver. So I used the Scent of Death just to level it up actually. Let's use Resolve. Superhuman Reflexes, Serrated Blade. And let's end it. Okay. So we can sell in town the stuff we don't need. Maybe this hand axe makes. Hammer, cape, dagger, bouncing dagger, and we can now equip the squares leather armor, and maybe the helmet. We can afford this cost. We have 555. Emerald Orb is quite nice. It heals a lot, both with the synergy and the heal. We have the nerfed bandit, which is still strong, but not insane like he used to be. We have Hyperion's Shrine, which doesn't fit our roleplay anymore. So as you can see, we have some pretty nice allies to pick from, including Yorick. Our clock advances here and stores will close at evening. Parasitic Ring. Synergy Bleed, Synergy Festering. That would be pretty nice against living enemies, but the more you use it, the more this hit point cost will become. And looking at the card, you will see that here it has 4 levels. And all you get is lose 6 hit points, seriously. No, because passing synergies to this version of the ring will give them a plus 4, while passing synergies to this version of the ring will give them plus 0. So it's a very nice part of your chain if you don't mind losing health, especially if the previous part is the one with the synergy healing. For example, that would work well. So let's look a bit more in this section. What I'm looking for is something with meditate. But there isn't it. Ah, there you are. Ever burning candle, and we can't afford it. That's exactly what I was looking for. What else we can get? Let's buy one of these and one of these. Necrosis, Echo 1, resist physical 2 and lose frostbite. That's a nice card to have if only for sideboard. Celestial Wrath. Upon draw, you craft a Celestial Wrath. It has Blessed and Wrath 8. Let's add this. I will add this to my stash. Leap of Faith. Let's use Leap of Faith. That's a lot of vulnerable. 7. Let's quick draw. So he's wicked, meaning that he's the only one who will benefit from our Scent of Death, but we are still smelling like death. So I will leave him unharmed. I don't care if he heals as long as he hasn't lost any hit points, and focus on killing this one. And the short thrust. Let's get the cloak, loose frostbite, nice. And I said that we can now equip this, and we have enough keep of one. And we can also equip this, and we have enough keep of two. True Sight, Vulnerable 3, Dispel Concealment and Draw 2, so it's quite nice. We can add it to stats. We can get also Passage to Afterlife, since Death Pact is an unreliable way to get it, if that's what you want. Let's add this to my deck and remove. Since we are here, we can also remove maybe one necrotic touch. So this one will be forced to heal. I don't want to spend all this damage on him. Maybe I can use this to draw another card. I will still go for this guy. Click. Kill him with the shield. And the boss is Mina. So here, this is a card that I probably don't want to play. Let's discard it. But this is a card that will be quite powerful. And Mina is dead. So we have Vengeance 1. Okay, so we are at stage 4, and this is where I will leave you, have a short break, and continue this video in a bit. I will be seeing you soon. Bye bye.